All right, so I've finished my import and now I want to change the name of my folders but keep the date. So I'm going to select the folder to which I want to change the name, and I'm going to right click or two finger click if I'm on a laptop and choose rename. And once I'm in that rename dialog, I don't want to get rid of the date. All I want to do is add the names that will help me identify the contents of this folder when I look at it. In this case, it got Barcelona, Train, Gaudi, and Roman Ruins. Once I've got what I want, I select Save, and you'll see now, if I float my cursor over the folder, because I don't see the whole name, if I float my cursor over the folder, I'll see the name of the folder that I typed. It'll also show me the volume of where it's located. Again, float your cursor over, wait, and then you'll see the folder name, and you'll also see the location where it is on your computer inside your Finder or your Explorer. Another way you can deal with the name if it's too long is you can float your cursor over the partition between the left panel and the image preview area. And when you see the slider icon, you can click and drag the panel over to reveal more of the file naming. And now, if you float your cursor over the folder, you'll not see the name of the folder, but you will see the location inside your computer as to the location of the folder. And now, to give you an idea of what this looks like over time, here's my version of Lightroom with my files and folders. Everything has a date, which puts it into chronological order, followed by a description as to what's inside that folder. And contrary to just naming your folders, which helps to tell you what's in them, dating them puts them into a better perspective as to when they happened. And this is my tried and true approach to organizing folders in Lightroom. This is Lightroom Guy. Thanks for watching.